Hi, everybody. This is Patty from A Soul's Heartbeat, and look what just arrived. Happy mail, happy mail, happy mail. This is from Manuela Ott in Zurich, Switzerland. Manuela and I have known each other for, oh my goodness, probably 10 years or more. And she is so sweet. She told me last year she was making me something, and she sent me a note about 3 weeks ago and says, it finished. I'm finally going to mail it. And it arrived on my doorstep just now. I have not even opened it or anything. So I'm going to pause the video, open it, and come back, and we're going to open it
together.
I have pulled everything out of the box. I've not looked at a thing except this gorgeous card. And it is overflowing. Underneath this tissue paper are stacks of stuff. Manuela, what did you do? Okay, this is a card. This is with texture paste. And you can see it almost looks burnished.
It says,
Dear Patty, I wish you a happy birthday. The stamps are secondhand. The vegetable and fruit peeler are my favorite kitchen tool. Ooh, I'm so excited. Okay, so I'm going to just start pulling tissue paper to the side here. Oh, and she made a book. Oh, my God. But I'm leaving that till the end. So let's see what else we have here. So we have, surprise, surprise, surprise. Oh, my goodness. All these different, she knows how I love this stuff. And I don't want to, I know this is crazy, but I don't want to ruin that washi tape because that is just cool. Look at that. Surprise, surprise, surprise. So she has all kinds of sentiment stamps. What do we have here? Oh, be fearlessly authentic. Oh, très chic. Oh, just all kinds of, I just love this stuff. Just love them. Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, there is so many. Wow, and I know it will be hard for you to see because so many of them haven't been used, so you can't really see. But after I get them mapped out on my, for my book, for my, to sort them, I will come back so you can see what they all look like. White Christmas wrapping, cozy tree. Oh, I love that. Okay, so I'm going to try to stick these back in here, and I'll come back with the next item. Okay, I was trying to figure out how in the world I'm going to do this, and I realized how many there are. I don't know the backstory behind this. I don't know if these are some she had that she has used, and she's no longer using them. I don't know if they are like a sale she found somewhere. I have no idea, but I'm just going to kind of take them apart and show.
After I started recording this, I realized how many stamps there were. So I'm just going to fast forward through some of these so that you can see what's here, but I'm not going to show you each little individual stamp. As I use them throughout the years, I'll tell you this came from Manuela in my Happy Mail box.
I want to show you what they will end up like. This is all of my stamps, and I have them coded by manufacturer. That was when I was using them and listing everyone I used, and I don't do that as much anymore. And then I have them here, and I have them on a database on my computer, so I can look for Monkey, and it will tell me where it's at and who made it and like that. So eventually, that's what I will be doing to these, but that's a project for next year, definitely not this year. And then let me show you how I store them. So that's my binder. And then I store them in the sleeves like this. And then the stamps are in the back. Now, if I don't have a picture of them, well, I guess I have a picture of all of these. If I didn't have a picture of them like these, then I would stamp them on the other side so I can just flip through. And I have this, the same numbers here as I had in that book. So if I want this Hero Arts with Sympathy, I would find it in my book over there or online on my database. And then I would go to the HE6, and here it would be. So that's just the way I do it. You know, everybody has their own systems. Okay, so I moved to a new box.
So as I pulled out more and more, I was just blown away. And there is just no way to show you each of them how I did here. So I'm just fast forwarding through, but I kind of wanted to fast forward so you could get an idea of how many were here. It is unbelievable. Manuela said that these were all ones she had bought to do cards, and she doesn't make cards anymore. So she knew she was going to be sending them all to me.
This is the first part of the package, everyone. And like I said, I hadn't opened it, so I had no idea. I'm going to put these right on top. All of the stamps she sent. There were these packages. So let's do this like that. And we'll just set those to the side. And let's see what's inside of these. Oh, wow. Oh, I like them already. Oh, yes. These are a potato peeler or a veggie peeler. I wonder if...
I got an email after I'd opened this, and she said she sent extras so I could share them with my kids. And I have tried them. They are absolutely marvelous. They are so sharp.
Let's see what's in this one. Oh, look at
this. Isn't this
pretty? Oh, wow. Look at this. Almost smells like it, or looks like it should smell like lavender, doesn't it? How pretty is that? And then there's this one. This is really different and packaged so beautifully. And you know what? I bet you 10 to 1 that she has put these all together herself. She put the strips on the fabric, I'll bet you. I'll have to find out when I ask her. So there's those. And now... there's this wonderful book that's been hiding back behind that she has made. So let's see what we have here. Oh my goodness. Look at this. Look at how it's textured and everything. And it says postcard. Oh. And this is like you've taken a piece of tissue paper like this and scrunched it all up. And then... Mod Podge, decoupaged over the top. Oh, look at this. Love the tag. Love the whole thing. And what a cool closure. Look at that. Is that just, and is it loose? Yes, loose all the way around the book. Just a double thing of elastic with the button. Great. And now this has two brushes. And she knows I love lavender and purple. That's why it's this color, everybody. Oh, look at, looky. Oh. I just love it. This is fabric on the inside here. And let me get a ruler and tell you. I think this is probably about a 4-inch spine. But let me see. let's see if I can get that to about there. It's a little over. Maybe 4 1/4. And then it is 8.5 by 6. 6 by 8.5 and about a 4.5-inch spine. Oh, wow. Oh, I love it. Let me move my camera down just a little. That's better because I want you to be able to see it. Oh, look at this. And all kinds of paper, and it's been tea-dyed or coffee-dyed. Oh, all different textures. Oh, my word. Oh, look at this. Oh. And now let me see if she has, let me find the middle of this one. Yep. See, each one has been stitched in 1, 2, 3, 4 with a 4-hole pamphlet stitch. Okay, then we have music or unlined paper that you could use for music. I would think that's what it's for. Oh, and this paper is so soft. And the tea stein thing. This is another one. Almost an onion skin feel on one side, but waxy on the other. So many different papers. Look at this. So pretty. And then we've got the coffee stain, a lined paper. Oh, my goodness. There are so many in here. Just so many. Oh. So much work. Oh, and now this is almost like what she, a little bit heavier, like packing material that you would have in like an Amazon package or something. Love it. Just love it. Look at this. Oh, I guess this is going to be my 2024 journal, huh? That I'll have to figure out what I'm putting in. And the spine is so wide that I can add lots of things to it and not have it
to kind of go over while I'm fast forwarding through the rest of the pages. When I spoke to Manuela, she said she had made me a book last year and I filled it, or a couple years ago, and I filled it with all kinds of cards and notes and letters that I have gotten from other crafty friends. And she made this one for that purpose. That is why it's so wide, so I would have so much more room to put stuff in it. But I don't know, I have to think about it. I might want to use it for something else. It's just so beautiful. I think I'd like to make it just into a type of a junk journal, but I'll have to really give it some thought. It'll take me a while. I'll go through it over and over again before I actually paste something to that very first page. I just love, love, love it.
Two, three, four, five, six, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 signatures. And in each one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 sheets in each one. Lots and lots of pages, my friend. Now, as I was doing this, I saw this fall out, and I don't know whether it was in the front or the back, but she does this a lot. Look at this. And then she has made it into, or it was an envelope, I don't know which, and she covered it. But she has taken things, come on, I don't want to tear it. Why are you being nasty here? Okay, there we go. There we go. Okay, what she's done is she has taken little things of the purples and three buttons and put them in here. So when I'm putting things in this album, along with the laces, I can use this to complete it. Oh, wow. And I'll have the same color or color scheme. And I have some other purple things that she has sent me over the years that I have hoarded that I guess I'll have to get out and put back in this. Oh, I'm going to take that out because here is some papers. Look at here. Oh, wow. Look at this. Isn't that pretty? This is really, really thick. And then here. And I can't tell if this was, I don't think that this was a real envelope. I think this is one that she has made completely herself because this is an acetate here. Oh, what can I say? The best gifts you made are those that come from the heart, from a friend. Oh, just, I'm just, oh, and I love this. My goodness, I just love that girl. Just love it. Oh, I don't know what to say. Thank you just is not enough. Somewhere down here hidden, and I don't, oh, here it is the card that she included too. So much work, so much time, so much love put into something like this. All I can say is from the bottom of my heart, I thank you, and I will cherish it, and I promise I will use it. It's so easy when you're gifted things like this to say, oh, beautiful, and you look at them, and then you put them on the shelf. Well, that's not what they're intended for. They're intended to be continued with love of your life. Things that are happening, special moments, whatever. And I hope I do this justice. Manuela, you are a sweet, sweetheart. I wish you didn't live all the way across the world in Switzerland. And I wish we could meet sometime. But this is the next best thing, my dear. You just made my day. So everyone, I will put her link to her social media below. And you can give her some love. But thank you. Thank you for joining me and looking at all of this. And oh my goodness, I'm going to be sorting stamps here. Oh, I'm just for eons. Hey everybody, have fun in your crafty space. If you're not a subscriber, I hope you will subscribe, like, and comment today. Share my video with a friend if anyone else you think they would like to see this beautiful book she made. And you know, you can get lots of ideas and inspiration by how someone else does what they've done. Now, I want you to see here too. See, this is not an attached spine. These signatures have been sewn into an extra, I don't want to see it here. An extra piece. So you can see down there, that's the board and the stiffeners. That way, this, and she's curved it, this, your book will lay flat no matter what page you're on because you've made that curved spine. And then this is the back cover. Oh, I just love it, and it's lavender. I'm just so happy. Okay, thank you for joining me. Have a great crafty day. Manuela, my friend, love you, my dear. Bye-bye, everyone.